What's a dictionary attack? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. If you're interested in getting tips, tricks, definitions like this and more in your inbox every week, head over to askleo.com/newsletter and sign up for my weekly Confident Computing newsletter. Dictionary attack is a phrase we often hear in security circles as one way that hackers attempt to basically gain access to resources they shouldn't. Usually it's a password attack. It's an attack on the different kinds of passwords that we're all using. It's important to understand what a dictionary attack is or is not. Typically, it doesn't actually use a literal dictionary. It's not using your dictionary from your desk or the dictionary that you think of as having a list of all the words in the English language. It could. Don't get me wrong, that is a dictionary, and that is one kind of attack, I suppose. But in reality, a dictionary is a more generic term for a list of words. And by words, I mean often things that aren't words. Examples of dictionaries would include a list of common passwords, a list of previously discovered passwords, a list of first names, a list of honestly just about anything. Again, not necessarily words, but things that are useful in the context of hacking passwords. So, the attack. We understand what a dictionary is. What's the attack? The attack is really simple. Try everything in the dictionary. Start at the beginning. See if that will work as a password. See if the next one works as a password. See if the next one works. Again, in most cases, this is all being done offline with stolen copies of databases. So the hackers have the time and can apply the resources to try these massive lists of passwords against what they have to see if any of them work. Especially with the list of previously discovered passwords, a frighteningly high number of those passwords will in fact gain them access to some of the accounts in the database that they have stolen. However, that's an offline attack, right? They've stolen the database and they have stored it on their computer, and now they're basically just whacking away at it with whatever technology they happen to have available. There's also what I call a persistent attack. Now, clearly, one of the pushbacks I get whenever I talk about brute force attacks or dictionary attacks is, well, if I try to sign in and I get my password wrong three times, it stops. It either locks me out or it slows me down or something like that. This is true. Hackers are very, very patient, or at least they can be. And in reality, it's not the hacker being patient at all. It's the machine or the botnet that they've set up to do this work for them. Here's what I mean. They may take one of these lists, one of these dictionaries of things they want to try as passwords, and they will try one on your account, and it will fail. They will come back a minute later and try the next one. A minute later and try the next one. A minute later, and try the next one. On and on and on in this very slow, but very persistent dictionary attack. And yes, it can take years for them to run across whatever happens to be the correct current password for your account. They don't care. They're not spending time on this. They have written a program. The program is running, and it is just doing this mindlessly until it comes up with a successful result. Now, in reality, they're probably doing it a little bit faster than that, right? Because not only are they not attacking only your account, they're attacking a bunch of different accounts, and there probably is no reason for them to delay between them. And they're usually doing this using a botnet, which means that the service that's being attacked can't even say, oh, this machine is being really problematic, because it's not that machine. It's hundreds of thousands of other machines that are compromised across the internet, and the service that's being attacked can't even blame it all on one machine to make it stop. One of the interesting things about being a server owner. And I think a lot of people that have servers may have run into this as well, is it's very interesting to take a look at the logs. When you sign into a service, there's usually a log of what you've done, who signed in, or the failed sign-ins. And I've seen this literally on my own server. There'll be a failure. A few seconds later, there'll be a failure. A few seconds later, there'll be a failure. My server, all servers, are under constant attack. Now, there's more to it than just passwords. I mentioned common first names as one of the dictionary lists, and that's because they don't even necessarily need to know the account username, because first name usernames are so incredibly popular. I'll admit, I use Leo as a username when I can. It's usually taken by the time I get to the big services, but on my own, absolutely. Same thing with pretty much any common first name. So, as part of the dictionary attack, they won't even try to figure out what accounts they're hacking. They'll just run through both the list of all the names that they have and the list of all the passwords that they have or are choosing to try. And yeah, they don't have to be successful very often, but they're successful often enough. And finally, it doesn't even have to deal with passwords. It can also be about spam. The username at Gmail, firstname@gmail.com, for example, I'm sure there's an account for every common first name, including Leo. I don't own it, but somebody does. I wasn't able to get it when I tried. Point being that, great, spammers don't really need to know the account names either. All they need to do is send spam to all the common first names against all the popular mail services, and some of them are going to land. A bunch of them are going to bounce. The spammers don't care. They're not paying attention to their bounces. The bounces may not even come to them. So they have a quick and easy way to send a lot of spam to a lot of people and actually have it work. Now, one of the things you may find that is a direct reaction to these kind of persistent dictionary attacks, and it's something that I've had to resort to myself, it's one of the reasons CAPTCHAs exist. Remember, I said a lot of this slow, persistent attack is being done by botnets. Great. So, to prove you are human, you are proving you are not a bot. That's why CAPTCHA exists, so that only real people are even given the opportunity to try to sign in. Anyway, I hope that helps you understand exactly what a dictionary attack is and how it might be used several different ways, probably several ways that really don't come to mind very quickly, but now we understand not only why there's so much spam, but more importantly, why every service is under constant attack and why they might make the barrier to entry just a little bit higher to you as a result. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/2747. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.